Right. Yeah, I know. It's not a perfect system, but since you knew that I didn't put a secret word, you get extra credit for that too. So if you guys, like, you know, are gone or you're confused, hi Joe, yeah, we figured it out. You know, rewatch the video, relive the best hour of your day at your home. Okay, so sorry, Borski, we forgot to record until now. It was Tiana's fault because she didn't remind me. But all we're doing today is, and this will be good for Joa also. So same thing as yesterday, except now we're doing definite integrals, Joa. So now we're actually finding a numerical answer. Okay. So if I decide to, if I'm doing this problem right here, I would let, we did this problem yesterday, u would equal 2x plus 1. So du equals 2dx. So when I substitute those into here, then I get this as my integral. Okay. Antiderivative of this stuff is this. And then from here you have two different choices. You can do what we did yesterday, which is to re-substitute back in what u is and then evaluate from 0 to 4. Or you could take these numbers right here and substitute them into the u substitution and use those as our limits of integration instead. Okay? And either way you do it, you're going to get the same answer. Yes?
Where do you put plus c?
There is no plus c in this case because we're not finding the general formula for the antiderivative. We're finding the numerical value. Okay? So in a definite integral, no plus c. In an indefinite integral, plus c. Okay? All right, so let's just finish this. So you'd plug 9 into here. What's 9 to the 3 halves? 27, and then 27 times 1/3 is 9. So that's going to be 9 minus. What do you do if you plug in 1? What do you get if you plug in 1? 1/3. And so my final answer would be 8 2/3. And I mean, we could be dorky and do it this way and show that you're going to get the same thing. If I plug 4 into there, then that turns into 9. 9 to the 3 halves is 27. 27 times 1/3 is 9. If I plug in 0 there, I get 1. To the 3 halves is still 1 times 1/3. So it works out to be the same thing either way. Okay? So it's just a matter of kind of personal preference. Yeah. Yeah. And so, Cameron, the real answer to your question, it said using 5, that's this rule right here. They want us, instead of substituting back in the end, they want us to change the limits of integration. Do it the different way. All right? Why it's 5?
Yeah.
Oh, they just labeled this box 5.
Oh.
Okay? Okay. So it's nothing to do with the math. That's just,
oh, okay.
There was another box earlier that must have been number 4.
Gotcha.
Okay? So it actually doesn't have anything to do with the calculus. All right. So let's try another one now that you know. Will you do this on your own? Elizabeth, will you please do this on your own? Elizabeth, oh my God, look out behind you. 3 minus 5x. What's du? Dx. Okay. All right, so now we start our substitutions, okay? So this becomes u squared. And then all I need is a dx. But I have this negative 5 here. So I have to go negative 1/5. Du. All right? And then, since this is what we're supposedly learning today, I'm going to go ahead and change this 1 into a... Nope.
Oh.
Negative 2, and I'm going to change the 2 into a... 7. All right? So now I have to rewrite this as u to the negative 2. No. Okay, good. Glad we're having that conversation. That's important. Yep, original order. So, no, I'm glad. That's a good question. So this is was 2, so it has to become negative 7. It doesn't switch places. Yes? Yes. Yes. Because that's, you could, yep. And then substitute back in, and then you'll get the same answer. Okay, so Logan? You have to do the antiderivative now. This isn't the answer. You don't plug these numbers into that. Okay, so what's the antiderivative of u to the negative 2?
It would be negative 1. U to the negative
Right.
I got
multiply this by the reciprocal.
So when you plug it into 1,
it's the negative 1. So negative 1 times, it just makes it a positive. Okay. And that is still from negative 2 to negative 7. But I can't do algebra with negative exponents, so I'm going to rewrite this as 1 over 5u from negative 7 to negative 2. Yes? And plug in the top one first, because you always go top to the bottom, right? So that's 1 over negative 35 minus, plug in the bottom one, 1 over negative 10. So these become pluses. What did you get for common denominators? Is it really 350?
No, I did one of the 14.
Is what?
I did one of the 14.
I don't see that.
That's what I got too.
Really? Did I screw something up?
Maybe.
I'm not seeing a 14.
The answer, those are the two.
Oh, what's my common denominator between 30? Oh, 70. Why did I go 350? Okay. So this is going to be negative 2 70ths plus 7 70ths. So that's 5 70ths, which is 1 over 14.
Okay.
Borski, party at Brooks' house on Saturday. It's going to be a rager. Okay, then the only thing that's left in this section is sometimes they throw these crazy things at you, and I just, there were going to be like two of you maybe that are going to catch this. Because if you are talking about area underneath a curve, if you have an even function, what's true about the graph? I can't hear you. Symmetric with respect to the y-axis. So if, coincidentally, you are taking the integral from negative a to a, so from this right here to this right here, of this thingy right here, and it's an even function, so it's symmetric, then what's true about this area right here and this area right here? They're the same. So one thing that you could do, they don't cancel out. Right, which we're going to do in a second. So one thing that you could do if you wanted to is instead of going from negative a to a, you could go from 0 to a and then double it. Yeah. And the only reason why that might be helpful is because sometimes it's a lot easier to plug in 0 than it is to plug in negative, right, exactly, 17. Okay. So that's if the function is even. If the function is odd, that's the situation that Jake was talking about. Jake got a little confused between even and odd functions. Even functions are symmetric with respect to the y-axis. Odd functions are symmetric with respect to the origin. So that would be like if we had this, okay? And if I went, thanks, from negative a to a, right, then this area right here is the same as this area right here, but this is below. Right, so that means that this answer is going to be 0, okay? So what's going to happen is, once or twice, they're going to throw this crazy problem at you, and you're going to be like, what the heck? How do I find the antiderivative of blah, 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 blah? But the thing that you're going to look at is you're going to go, oh, this is an odd function from negative a to a, so the answer is just 0. And there's only going to be like one or two of you that are going to catch that. Okay, be that person. How do you know if it's odd? Okay, great question. So give me a function that we know is odd.
Negative x squared
is even because the exponent is even. So the way that you find out if a function is even is you plug in negative x. So if I take negative x and I plug it into here, remember you have to do the exponent first. So negative x times negative x is x squared, and then I make my answer negative, so I get negative x squared. So since these are the same, wow, that means it's even, okay? Give me a function that is odd.
x cubed,
let's get a little bit crazier, x cubed plus x, okay? Now if I plug in negative x, since I'm going to an odd power, what's negative x times negative x times negative x? Negative x cubed, and then plus negative x. And so since these are the opposite of each other, then it is odd. Okay? That's how you tell even and odd functions. All right? So what? Yeah, or the easier way to do it is to plug in a number and then the opposite of that number. And if you get the same answer, then that's even. And if you get the opposite answer, then it's odd. And you could get unlucky and just like randomly pick one number that happens to work for that, but that's fairly unlikely. So it's a good thing. Right. Yes, that'll be your clue. Right. That'll be right. So you're going to be the guy. Okay, if I can get you guys, wait, not quite done with you. Okay, so for example, if you are asked to find the integral from negative 2 to 2 of x to the 6 plus 1, you know that this is an even function, because if you plug in negative x to an even power, the negatives will just cancel and it'll be x to the 6, okay? So instead of doing it from negative 2 to 2, you can change and go from 0 to 2. And then, like I said, that's nicer because if this was a negative 2, you'd have to go like negative 2 to the 7th power, and that's going to be some crazy number, and is it negative or positive, blah, 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 all that stuff instead. Yeah, well, true. So you can do it either way, right. So you can do it either way. It's just like what we just did with the substitution. You can also do that either way. If you want to do it from negative 2 to 2, that's fine. But all this is showing is that if you go from 0 to 2 and double it, it works out to be the same, okay? That's fine. Well, I guess we'll find out when you're actually doing some of those problems. Okay, now this right here is a great example. If I gave you this problem right here, you would look at this and you'd go, wait a minute. If I make my u substitution be 1 plus x squared plus x to the fourth, then the derivative is 2x plus 4x cubed, and that's not in there anywhere. And if I made u equal tangent of x, then the derivative of tangent x is secant squared, and that's not in there, so I'm totally clueless, I don't know what to do. But like Cameron said, the clue is we're going from negative 1 to 1, negative a to a. And this turns out to be an odd function. Okay, and you could test that on the calculator by, like I said, just picking a number for x. Do you want to do that?
No,
just for funnies? Colby wants to do it. It's an odd function because, give me a number for x. I'm talking to Colby. 2, thank you. So if I go tangent of 2 divided by 1 plus 2 squared. Thank you. Then I get this as an answer, okay? Then if I plug in negative 2, the opposite of that, and I have to be careful doing this because of the negative, so I have to go 1 plus parentheses negative 2 squared plus parentheses negative 2 to the fourth. Then I get the same answer opposite sign. So that means I know that it's an odd function. And so now the integral from negative 1 to 1, I'm going to have the same area above the curve as I am below on the other side. So the answer is just 0. Okay? Good?
Are all trig functions going to be an odd?
Great question. So the tangent function is an odd function because I'm sure you recall the graph looks like that. Okay? What about the sine function? Starts at 0 and then goes the other way this here. So sine of x is an odd function, okay, because it's reflected from here to here. And then cosine starts at and then goes down. And so we got the same thing going over here. So that one is going to be even. So that's a really great question. So sine is an odd function, cosine is an even function, and tangent is even. Oh, absolutely. Yes, yes. Because how weird is this? This polynomial on the bottom was an even function because this is technically to the 0 power, the 2nd power, and the 4th power. So those are all even, so that's even. But this is an odd, and an odd divided by even came out to be an odd. So you that definitely is going to change things, but that's a clue. That's a good start.
Can we just graph all the functions?
Yep, you could do that.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. So you want to come up with like some little... Well, you guys are going to... Yeah, you're going to explore that a little bit on your... Because you just sit there and do nothing? Okay, so what are we on here? Five? Don't forget, there's advisory today, guys. Yep.